Hello everyone, this is AeroPowered Sid, and welcome to my brand spanking new Let's Play. I decided to do this one completely on a whim because I guess I'm a little bit excited about Resident Evil 6 coming out soon enough. We got about 100 some odd days. And anyways, welcome to Let's Play
Resident Evil.
Exactly, and no, I do not want to sign in. This is going to be a single-player game, purposefully. The reason being is because, well, I still need to toy around with the settings before I can even attempt to record multiplayer with two people, you know, one across the internet and everything like that. I still have to work around that, and it is possible that I could do a future LP of this game that is co-op, but for right now, I'm just going to stick with single player as such and just go with that. I'm going to do my best to show a 100% playthrough of this game. You know, show you where all of the BSAA medals are and, you know, all the treasures, or at least tell you how to get the treasures anyways. I'm not guaranteeing a 100% playthrough though, but I will do my best to tell you where everything is in the game so you yourself can do a 100% playthrough, because I know that at least one of the BSAA medals you have to have two players playing. It is not an option. You have to really have two people playing, and it's ridiculous how they did that. But all the same, it doesn't really matter. Let's go ahead and start up a new game, and we will be playing on normal, just because I'm pretty decent at this game after playing it a couple of times. Co-op setting is rogue. Attack reaction? Nah, not really. I would prefer not to have them on. So let's start the game and watch the opening cutscene, and if you want to, you can read the history of Resident Evil right here and pause the game, or pause the video, I'm sorry. So, here we go.
Captain Deschat here. We've secured the underground route to the coordinates.
Not to spoil anything right now, but remember them for later. I will actually point it out later anyways.
I should have seen it coming. It didn't take long after the fall of the Umbrella Corporation for their bioweapons to end up in the hands of terrorists. A new era of bioterrorism descended upon vulnerable countries, shifting the balance of power throughout the region. People in the destabilized areas soon feared another incident like Raccoon City was inevitable. As panic spread, governments of the world turned to the Global Pharmaceutical Consortium, which formed the anti-terrorism unit, BSAA. Operatives of the BSAA were sent to infiltrate and neutralize bioterrorist hotspots, restoring safety and stability to various regions around the globe.
Ass shot!
Welcome to Africa. My name is Sheva Alamar.
Chris Redfield.
Your reputation precedes you, Mr. Redfield. It's an honor.
Just Chris, thanks. So you'll be accompanying me to the destination?
Yes. Tensions are running high ever since the change in government.
I'll bet. Intel says it's a haven for terrorists now.
And I'm not going to be happy to see an American, BSAA or not. That's why I'm your partner. Help put them at ease.
Well, I'm sure you'll do just fine. Partner.
You okay?
Yeah, sorry. It's nothing. Let's go. Casualties continue to mount over the long years I've struggled. More and more, I find myself wondering if it's all worth fighting for. Maybe one day, I'll find out.
Hey, Uyo Ngeti, alafanya nini hapa?
You don't have to get touchy.
Yes, he does.
Let's go.
There is one thing I do know. I have a job to do, and I'm gonna see it through.
You know, I can feel the friendly atmosphere already. Yeah, I don't think I really am. All right, well, here we go.
This is Kirk. Chris, Sheva, can you read me?
Chris here. Coming in loud and clear, Kirk.
Yes, we read you.
There's a black market weapons deal going down in Kijuju. That's where Irving will be. Alpha Team has already infiltrated the area, and you will be going in as backup. Rendezvous with your contact at the butcher's shop. You can gear up and get briefed on the mission there. Watch your backs.
Roger that.
Copy. Over and out.
Oh, hey, let's check out what's going on over here. Wow, they move fast. Anyways, yeah. I will admit that this is not at all my favorite Resident Evil. That spot's already been taken up by 4, followed by Revelations. I really actually like that game. But anyways, this game is not necessarily my favorite in the series, but I will admit that Capcom did a good job with the graphics on it. It's quite beautiful. What the hell are they beating? So they're beating it, and I bet they stop and just take a look at me, and yeah, the sack finally stopped moving, so whatever was in there, oh well. Doesn't really matter. You can run by holding X, obviously. The game will tell you that later, but right now we need to go up here. Holy shit, we're in a village full of ninjas. We are screwed. Yeah, whatever. We have to pretty much go up there on the map where it's got the yellow pulsing thingamajig. Yeah, that. Alright, well, here we go. Let's just open it, and hello. It's a man wearing a turban. Let's talk to him.
Good, you're both here. Come.
Yeah, if you try talking to him whenever Sheva is not with you, he'll just basically say, hey, where's the other guy? So you have to actually talk to him with both characters at the same time.
You too. This way. But maybe because of the new government, the people around here are a little on edge. You should do what you came here to do and go home.
Yeah, they really roll out the red carpet for us Americans.
I have your weapons for you here. Jet them. Grab your weapons. The operation's already started.
Let's go ahead and grab that. So, see your inventory here by hitting triangle. Or I'm pretty sure if you're playing the 360 version, it would be the Y button. But, or if you have your weapons on the up, down, left, or right. All you have to do is go to the D-pad and hit up, and you'll automatically equip whatever is adjacent to those four buttons.
Destination coordinates?
Town square's up ahead. Go through there. Alpha team's waiting at the deal location.
Good.
What do you know about Ouroboros?
Mostly just rumors. Something about visions of a Doomsday project.
Doomsday sounds about right, and apparently it is no rumor.
You're kidding, right?
You must find a man named Irving. He's our only lead. And be careful out there.
Yeah, we really should be careful. So let's go over here. If you use L2, or I'm guessing on the 360 version it would be the LB button, you'll use your knife, so let's break open that box. I'm going to pick that up. I was originally going to do this Let's Play whenever I got the game for the 360, the Gold Edition actually, but because I can never find it, I said screw it, I'll just go ahead and do the PS3 one. And also, with the Resident Evil, I'm going to go ahead and pause it just to explain this really quick. With Resident Evil 6, the US is getting two kinds of collector's edition, so to speak. For the 360 version, they both cost $90, but for the 360 version, you get download codes for Resident Evil 5 Gold Edition, Resident Evil 4, Resident Evil Code Veronica X HD, just like 4 HD, and Resident Evil Degeneration, which is a movie. For the 360, I only have essentially the Degeneration movie, but for the PS3 owners, you'll get a download code for Resident Evil, Resident Evil 2, Resident Evil 3, Resident Evil 4, Resident Evil 5 Gold Edition, and you'll get the game 6. So I've already got all of those games for the PS3, so I found no reason to really buy the collectors for the PlayStation 3. But for the 360, I went ahead and pre-ordered that collector's edition, and unfortunately, I would not get the download codes until the game came out, so that's why I'm recording it now on the PS3, and I don't feel like going out to hunt down a copy just to buy it, only to get it later. So that's why I'm doing it here. But if you read the document, it just explains control types here, and I already know them, so if you want to read it, just pause the video, and there you go. Wait. That was control types. I wonder if this is the same thing. No, this explains dying status. Which, once again, just read it if you really want to. If you really want to read it, just pause the video. But I already know what to do,
remember,
so I don't really care.
Whatever happens, stick together.
Don't worry. I may not be as big as you, but I can still hold my own.
Is that an innuendo? I really don't know. Oh, that looks just a tad bit disturbing. Can I skip that? I really don't want to look at a dead goat's ass. Haha! Shot a crow. That wasted a bullet too, man. So, wait, let's investigate that. No goat. Yep. There we go. The body's still warm. Why is this here? Well, because someone clearly has issues, but wow, you can kind of see here how. Yeah, this place doesn't look too friendly. Let's open up this door and whoa! Holy crap, dude, what is going on? I really don't know, Chris. I really don't know. And Sheva, your AI partner, will kind of break some things for you. Let's go ahead and pick up more money and pick up a green herb, which will come in very handy later. Well, later. Whew! I've never actually read this document before, but I'll read it later. Whenever I make the video and pause it. So, there you go. Now, if I was doing a speedrun of this game, however, yes, I would have just ignored everything in there.
Did you hear that? It came from that building.
Yeah, thanks for teaching me how to run game after I figured it out on my own.
Freeze! Are you okay?
I'm pretty sure your eyeballs shouldn't bleed like that. Okay, this just got bad. Haha, stomp on him again. Stomp on him again. Or let Sheva finish him off, absolutely.
What the hell just happened?
They didn't move like any zombies I've ever seen.
Wait, really? I just push his body a little bit? Okay, that's actually kind of funny. But, yeah. That was something that was very uncanny. You don't see that every day. And on that note, I'm going to stop the video right here and pick up next time on Let's Play Resident Evil 5. So thank you all for watching. I will see you there.